Thank you. Thank you so much for your kind presentation, Malik. It's always a pleasure and honor for me and for my colleagues from Eurythmics to present the report. We are part of the movement. We are a resilience center based in the movement, and this is for us a great privilege. So once again, here we are presenting the report. From today, you can download the 2017 edition from the website www.monitor.coop. And I want to start thanking again the two main sponsors that have supported our work, from Brazil, OCB, and from Spain, the Foundation Espreyo. The report is not about boring statistics. It's about business intelligence. And this is an important point because, you know, business intelligence is an ever-growing factor in business competition. The most innovative businesses around the world have already gone down the road of a more intensive use of data they collect and produce. And this is a big transition to a knowledge economy in which extensive and detailed information on market, on clients, on needs, on community assumes priceless value for developing new products and new services. This is the reason why big players like Amazon, like Google, like Apple have such a huge success. They deal with data, they collect data, they use data better than others. If the cooperative movement so desires, it could quickly become a champion on the data economy. We could be a champion of the data economy, and because we are widespread at international level, because we are a network that is present in every country, we have a huge potential in terms of business intelligence. This is an immense potential, but this potential isn't yet seized by cooperatives. I show here some work that has been done recently using the data elaborated by the monitor, and they are works done by academics and researchers. In these first 5 years, the monitor has been used intensively to present the cooperatives to external audiences. I believe that in the next 5 years, we should learn to use the data, the monitor, and more additional data in order to improve upon goods and services directed towards our members and our communities. The monitor can be an instrument for the internal knowledge and for a kind of management tool for our cause. This is not yet understood, but this is a critical point in order to enter into the knowledge economy and to let the monitor in such kind of tool becomes a business intelligence for the movement. A second point I want to underline is that cooperative movement thrives on its diversity. One single global ranking cannot reproduce all this variety. That's clear. Therefore, it's so important to enhance and develop research at the national level, at the level of each single country, but with a homogeneous methodology. And this is what has been done over the years. The monitor has both utilized and been a reference point for national rankings. Classification and definitions used by the monitor have been used to produce reports at the country level. This tendency should be supported, should become a priority of the Alliance and of the national federations. Data analysis should be considered a critical activity. And in the future, every federation, every country should have its own data room. Data room is an infrastructure in which to compile cross-sectoral information that can help identify new, with greater precision, new trends in the market, in the society, can help our enterprises to identify new products, new services, to adapt and to react to the changes. So we need to get used to thinking in terms of cognitive innovation. Cognitive innovation is a kind of innovation that creates an increased distance between businesses that anticipate trends and businesses that are forced to follow behind. And we want cooperatives to be among the innovators, not among the followers. So many of the large cooperatives in this room already use business intelligence, but they buy this intelligence from commercial services that often have no or limited to no knowledge of the cooperative model. Why not think about taking advantage of the intercooperative dimension and having our own instruments? This is a challenge that we believe we could easily afford. Over the years, the Monitor has also proposed examples of in-depth analysis. As of last year, we had an analysis of cooperative capital. It's part of the 2016 and of the 2017 report. This year we focused not only on the top 300 larger cooperatives, but also on a sample of small cooperatives. And we discovered interesting things. For instance, that is not the cooperative model that limits capitalization. Size, sector, and regional areas have more impact than the belonging to the cooperative model. Contrary to the traditional theory of cooperative capital, the analysis of large cooperatives showed that they have a sufficient internal capital resources to support their growth. So the topic, the focus should be the low capitalization of the small cooperatives or the startup. And we should, I mean, focus our action, our attention, our activity on reducing the gap of this sector of our movement. And this is more specific. This gives an idea to us of how, I mean, trying to develop specific instruments for that gap. Another achievement, a fourth achievement that we got during these 5 years is that collecting data, consistent data on the performance, allows also the identification of key trends. For instance, we saw during these 5 years of Monitor, we saw a strong and healthy cooperative sector overall. You see, the trend has been always a trend increasing during the last years. And those years were the years of the worst crisis, economic crisis, in some of our countries. And now we arrive to this year's annual report. I know you are curious, but you have the leaflet on your chair, so you already know that we have investigated this year the first 300 cooperatives. They are just a part of our database. We have more than that. We have 3,000 cooperatives, and we want to enlarge this. We want to expand this database. So this year numbers are here. You see the data from 2017 report, Monitor, have a total turnover of $2.1 trillion. That is more or less aligned with last year. Taking into account the change in methodology, we introduced also the international dollar in order to have an instrument to compare across countries. We have a slight growth of this figure. One more point I want to underline. Another function of the Monitor has been to highlight that corporate enterprise can also be large businesses that can serve millions of users, of people, and that can generate large-scale impact. Highlighting these champions, these are the top 10 of this year, is not to say that small cooperatives that respond to the need of local communities are less important, of course. The argument that justifies the top 300 is that doing so, we are demonstrating that the extreme flexibility and adaptability of the cooperative model that includes all size of firms, from tiny to huge. This argument serves to counter those who erroneously claim that that the cooperative model only works in marginal contexts and in case of market failure. So this is an important argument in order to oppose this idea. To conclude, I would like to underline three very quick points that are challenges for the future, challenges that the cooperative model has to face. The first one is about the effect of concentration. I think it's a very critical point. I mean, you see this table. This table says that during the last decades, large corporations have been reducing the number of people employed. So on the left you see when the time was when corporations like General and Motors had 100,000 employees, and on the right you have the new big players, the new giants, the web giants, the GAFA, so Google, Amazon, Facebook and Apple, that have a huge amount of resources, financial resources, but less and less employees. So you have, there is really a dramatically dropped in the number of employees. So the superstar firm model is characterized by winner takes most competition. This means that a small number of highly profitable firms commands growing market share without low level share. Well, this is the effect of concentration. But the role of cooperatives can oppose the effects of concentration. And because the cooperatives, both they are place-based in communities, they are rooted in context, and so they are a natural instrument in order to strengthen the links with labor at local level. And also they have a different way, a different model of scaling up. That is a scaling up made through networks, through consortia, through second level. A scaling up that keeps, at the base, the capability to mobilize labor. And those two elements identify the cooperative model in a unique way and gives to the cooperative model a strength to oppose the general trend to concentration that is really unbelievable as a strength. Another point is about automation. Also, automation is a clear trend in our time. We witness a great decoupling. Large part of the employment that technology destroys is not reborn in other sectors. That's clear. We heard yesterday Dr. Yu saying this. So the technologies are evolving more quickly than our skills and organization. And the consequence is a profound restructuring of the workforce. We know that computers have matched humans in many skills and abilities. This means that new jobs, if we want to create new jobs, we have to incorporate in these new jobs more skills based on human interaction, on emotional intelligence, on empathy. And these are typically social skills that cannot be replaced by machines, by artificial intelligence. Well, the cooperatives, as people-centered enterprises, combine exactly social organization, orientation, an inclusive approach, an ability to identify emerging social needs, relational skills, proximity to users, worker participation in the decision-making process, gender equality, high motivation among workers, all elements that give to the cooperative model a specific advantage in providing a structured and stable infrastructure for the work of the future. And here the theme is, how can we exploit and bring to the forefront this advantage? Finally, these transformations are just the tip of the iceberg. A wide set of change is affecting our societies with an increasing number of unmet social needs. At the same time, we see that the stock of social capital is lower than in the past, and our society feel a lack of social trust that is strongly perceived as a major issue. Building a sense of common good, a common good capable of overcoming this social fragmentation, is becoming a priority for all of our countries. And we can observe a growth of social dimension in all businesses. Also in for-profit businesses, in shareholder businesses, we see that there is an increased sensitivity towards this theme. Well, in this work framework, there is a huge space for a new season for cooperatives. So building a new social construction, being part of creating new trust in the society is our responsibility, is our role. So, concluding, I know these challenges could seem to have nothing to do with the monitor, but considering what I've said at the beginning, the monitor and the national report should develop towards including indicators that show the value of the cooperative contributions to tackling these great challenges. This is the point. This is our challenge. It should be a priority of the cooperative movement to be at the forefront of this movement towards social indicators, indicators of social progress. And my question to you all, to the president, to the delegates, is very simple. Are we ready? Are we ready over the next years to render the monitor able to measure our movement contribution to the social progress? I hope the answer will be yes, we are. Thank you.